Mr. Dash, because we've been speaking a lot about French projects, so we should now talk about also what's happening here in India. So I'm very happy to welcome you as a speaker.
It's about CESC system. So it is the first integrated utility, electricity utility in India, operating since 1899, so about 120 years. So we supply in and around the city of Kolkata. Licensed area is 567 square kilometer. We have own generation embedded in our distribution system, 1125 megawatt, all thermal, coal-fired. So apart from that, we have contracted long-term capacity of 600 megawatt. And our peak demand is nearly 2200 megawatt, 2159 exactly. So balance we import from, mostly from exchange. Now units sold is about, near about 10,000 million unit. And number of HT consumers 1800, mostly at 6 kV. And we have total more than 3 million customers. So this is about CESC system, and present day loss is around 9%, and that includes losses in EHB system, unlike other distribution companies, where they account losses 30 kV and below. So if you take into account the losses that EHB system, or if you deduct that, then the loss in true distribution system is maybe around 7 to 8%. Now, smart grid journey started long time. We have SCADA, EMS, DMS for our HV system for quite a long time. SCADA was installed first in 1995. So then about one third of 6 kV feeders, mostly 6 kV, we have about 20% 11 kV in the fringes and mostly 6 kV because of legacy system. So one third of such feeders are automated. So we have done AMI project in select areas. And apart from that, for all HT and high value LT consumers, they are with AMR. So apart from that, we have put 3,000 smart meters on GPRS for some customers. All DTRs are on AMR. So we could do activities like planning on that AMR data. Now, all street lights are fitted with, we call it smart street light management system. There we have AMR, overload circuit breaker, and dust to dawn controller. You see, that is one potential area for unauthorized use. So tapping that area helps a lot in controlling the distribution losses. Then about 27 megawatt, not much, out of say peak demand of 2100. So there is solar PV already integrated, and all are under net metering arrangement as per provisions of regulations. And we did one pilot project with auto demand response, but frankly speaking, as of now, since there is no dearth of power availability, power is plenty, and so there is not program for scaling up such demand response project. Now coming to the basic question, why storage? So we did a lot of jobs, we took a lot of actions in smart grid arena, but not in storage area. Now we are interested in it. Why storage? So we expect large scale rooftop integration in our system. So we all know the government of India has a target of 100,000 total solar capacity. Out of that, 60,000 will come from ground mounted and 40,000 from rooftop. So till date, ground mounted is about 24,000 or so. So 40% they have achieved. And rooftop, so not much, only 1.5 gigawatt out of 40 gigawatt, so less than 5%. So there are various schemes, reports, orders, directives, etc. by the government of India. So to accelerate. So once it is accelerated, then there will be effect on our system as well. So there is chance of large-scale integration of rooftop in our system as well. So that is one area for what we are thinking about storage. Then there is aggressive program for transport sector. We all know by the government of India, say 30% of EVs will be, 30% of cars will be EV by 2030, et cetera, et cetera. So that is one area for what we are thinking about storage. Then now our biggest concern is availability of land and right of way for laying cables in heavily congested city like Kolkata. So recently we have set up one underground substation just due to the reason that there is not no appropriate land available. So, though it is costly, we have to go for underground. Now another area for what we can think of storage is absolute 24/7 supply. We supply 24/7 in the city. There is no outage at all, but even then, because of cable fault or because of maintenance, at some point there could be some outage. But for some important installations like hospitals, etc., absolute 24/7 supply is required. They maintain diesel generator sets, what they run at least once in every week for say half an hour. So if we can provide storage there, so we can avoid such diesel generators and also in environment friendly manner. Now this is impact of solar power grid. So on the left side, there is one consumer put rooftop solar, I'll name that is the airport authority. They have put solar in Calcutta airport. So during night time and early morning, they draw power from grid. During daytime, there is a push towards grid and it is substantial. You see, about 5 megawatt they draw during night time and the same megawatt, 5 or 6 megawatt, they push through the grid. And moreover, there is intermittency. You can see there are kicks. So that is a concern. Another concern is, you see, system load curve. For most of the time in a year, the peak occurs during evening time, during dusk time, there will be sharp demand growth. So gradient will be very high. So from system control operation point of view, managing the system and scheduling the power would be a challenge if there is large scale solar integration in our system. This is about EV penetration. We are getting ourselves ready. We have already put up some chargers. Now we have a plan to put up some more chargers in and around city. Now we have a plan for local storage. So it won't be beyond the meter, it will be before the meter in our distribution network. Maybe near the distribution transformer or maybe at the distribution pillar box. Now this is about storage implementation of storage in important installations like hospital we discussed. We can think of the floodlight for sports arena. They use diesel generators. We can use such storage there as well. So this is our load duration curve. So this is a concern. So our, though I said that our peak demand is 2159, but beyond 2000, it occurs only for few occasions, only for few time slabs. If we can avoid with storage, maybe distributed, maybe at higher level, say 30 kV level or 6 kV level. So if we can supply the remaining power, say 100 or 200 megawatt from such storage, so we can avoid or we can defer a large scale investment in our not only distribution network at low voltage or 6 kV or 30 kV, but also at our 132 kV or 220 kV, which is highly capital intensive in city areas due to underground cables. Now, while we are already, while considering the project, we find these are the challenges. So application, suitable application in distribution system, where to put, location, whether it will be near the transformer level or 6 kV level or 30 kV level, and what would be the sizing, even if it is distribution, say 150 kWh or 200 kWh, what would be the kW, etc. And there is a concern or challenge about control and communication. And also, we didn't find any cost benefit. So that is a challenge for us, how to get cost benefit. And also, the last but not the least challenge is the suitable technology partner. We are looking up for a suitable technology partner. But at the same time, we have to keep in mind that what is our duty as per the law, as per the act, our duty is to develop, maintain, and efficient coordinated and economical distribution system in our area of supply so that it doesn't put much pressure on our consumers. So the way forward and our, that is my personal key recommendation. At present, we are undertaking a study with acknowledged expert. So how to go forward? So our plan is to implement one pilot this year. Though the costs are coming down, lithium ion still prohibitively expensive for storage. So we expect adequate grant for the pilot project for implementation. Thereafter, we'll scale it up. And that's the proposal from my side is, you see, since there will be not much cost benefit analysis, initially, regulator may allow some kind of investment which would not impact certain paisa on the average cost of supply. But beyond that, once we do that, then after that, we hope that there will be cost benefit and we'll get adequate return on it. Thank you.